Somebody was asking what I would do from that, the end of that last technique. So once I've taken the back in that side bride position, where my go-to would be. Okay. So. Okay. So I've got lots of options from here. You know, for jiu-jitsu, I can look at taking the back. All these things. For MMA, I might want to sit here and hit. Control, that's fine as well. Okay. Just because it's the end of the day, I'm going to throw in something a little bit flashy. This is actually a higher percentage technique than it looks. I get quite a lot of success with this. So, take it face value. What I'm going to do is I'm going to put this hand in through from here, almost as though I'm going for a dart. Okay. So, I'm going to throw this hand through and I'm going to grip the hands together, palm to palm. Okay, elbows down, and from here I'm going to bump onto his side. Yeah, I want to hook a leg. It doesn't really matter which one. Okay, just put one of them. Okay, under here. Then I'm going to roll my belly button back of his head, squeeze my elbows in, and then push my hips forward. Okay, Japanese necktie.
That worked the end.
Okay. So here, bump onto the side, hook the leg as he goes, push the hips forward, lift the legs back. It is both a choke and a neck crank. If anyone asks you at a grappling competition, it's a choke because if you don't let go, they'll pass out before you break their neck. I have a sample size of one to prove this. Okay. And go through. Both palms up, and it's thumbs out. Okay. So, palm to palm. Okay. So, bump him. I put the leg. I roll. Belly button on the back of his head. Okay. I like to triangle my legs. It makes it harder for him to rear the leg out. And I just push my hips forward. Okay. And you don't keep them there for 2 minutes while you carry on talking. I made that mistake once.